Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I'm talking about sampling methods. In the last video, I talked about random samples and simple random samples, and I just wanted to start there again and just say these are the really important methods that people use frequently, and we can get good results by using these methods. We have random number generators. You can go to a website, randomnumber.org, I think is one of them, but also on your calculator, you can generate random numbers. And that's a good way for people to choose or sample the population. Another method is systematic. And in systematic, you select some starting point and you select every kth element in the population. So in this particular picture, we're starting with this house and then we're going every third house. So that's systematic because we just choose a starting point randomly and then we survey every third house. So systematic is one way that people might go to a phone book and choose a name and then choose every 10th name in the phone book. So it's random, but there's a systematic way of going about that. Another one is a convenience data, and that's just subjects are selected because they are nearby or easily accessible to the researcher. So in this particular picture, like people are sitting in a restaurant and somebody saying, hey, does anyone in here believe that college should be free? And that would be a convenience study because they're just literally turning to people around them and saying, let's answer this question. And you can probably see the weakness in that case. If you've ever been to a mall and you walk past and somebody says, hey, do you have time to answer a few questions? That's just a convenience. They're just having to grab somebody at the mall. But maybe they only want people that come to a mall, right? So they don't want to randomly go to a phone book and look up people. They want to know maybe their population is all the people that go to the mall. And so that they can use that population to answer their question. And then we also have stratified random sampling. So random sampling we talked about was we picking people in a random way, like drawing out a hat or using a random number generator. But what this does is divide a population into subgroups or strata, which is why it's called stratified. We divide them into strata, and then random samples are taken in proportion to the population from each of the strata created. So in this particular picture, you can see I have the numbers 1 through 12, but some were blue, some red, and some green. And so we organize those, all the blue together, all the red together, and all the green together. And then randomly from that, we select one of these three, which was 10. We selected one of these green ones, which was 5. But because there were twice as many red, we chose 2 from the red because we want to take it in proportion to the population. So you could put your groups might be freshmen, sophomores, juniors, and seniors in a high school. And then if the freshman population was way bigger than the other ones, we would have more in our final sample. So we stratify, and then we randomly sample from that strata, from each of the strata. And then finally, we could do a cluster study. So in the cluster study, the researcher divides the population into separate groups called clusters. Then a simple random sample of clusters is selected from the population. And then the researcher conducts his analysis on data from the sampled cluster. So what I have pictured here are 6 of the local high schools in my area. And let's say that I wanted to find out how high schools felt about the cost of college education. And I want to find out how freshmen feel, how sophomores feel, how juniors feel, how seniors feel about it. And I can't talk to every high school student in my area. So I take the 6 high schools that I have, and then I choose one of them randomly. And I go and talk to everybody in that high school. So in the stratified, notice that I'm breaking them up into groups, but I'm only taking some from each group, right? In a cluster, the difference is you break them up into groups, and then you talk to everybody in one group. So I think this is North Thurston. Maybe I would choose North Thurston. I would go to North Thurston and talk to everybody in that high school about how they felt about it. Or maybe I would choose Tumwater and North Thurston and talk to 2 of them. But the idea is that I break them up into groups, and then I talk to everybody within the group that I chose. Maybe you'd want to find out how people felt about the local bus transit system. And so every cluster is the people on a bus. And then you'd wait till the bus stops, and you'd choose that bus, and everybody who got off, you would ask them a question. So you cluster them, and then you talk to everybody in there. different here because you've got strata, and then you take some from each strata. So those are different, but sometimes get confused as being similar. All right, have a fantastic day.